He is the one still of the suffering of the three kinds of suffering, the one with an endless ending of the three, having gone to the liberation of the three. He is the one definitely freed from all obscuration, the one who abides in space-like equality. He is the one past the stains of all disturbing emotions, the one understanding the three times as a non-time. He is the great Naga, chief of all sentient beings, the crown of those wearing the crowns of good qualities, definitely freed from all residue bodies. He is the one well established in the track of the sky, bearer of a great wish-fulfilling dream. He is the master of all pervasive, ultimate of all jewels. He is the great and bounteous wish-granting tree, the superlative great face of excellence, the agent fulfilling the aims of all sentient beings, the wisher of the benefit. He is the one with parental affection towards sentient beings. He is the knower of what is wholesome and what is unwholesome, the knower of timing, the knower of the closed bond, the keeper of the closed bond, the master of the all pervasive. He is the knower of the faculties of limited beings, the knower of the occasion, the one skilled in the three kinds of liberation. He is the possessor of good qualities, the knower of good qualities, the knower of the dharma, the auspicious one, the source of what is auspicious. He is the auspiciousness of everything auspicious, the one with the auspicious signs of renown, the famous constructive one. He is the great bread, the great festival, the great joy, the great pleasure, the show of respect, the one showing respect, the prosperous one, the supremely joyous, the master of fame, the glorious one, possessor of the best. He is the provider of the best, the most preeminent, suitable for refuge. He is the superlative refuge, the very best for of the great frightful things, the eliminator of what is frightful without an exception. Wearing his hair in a bun, he is the one with a bun of hair. Wearing his hair in mats, he is the one having matted locks. He is the one draped with a munja grass sacred core, the one wearing a crown, the one with five faces, five ones of hair, and five knotted locks is crowned with a bloom. He is the one maintaining great taming behavior, the one with a shaved head, the one with celibate Brahma-like product, the one with a superlative taming behavior, the one with great trials, the one who has completed the trial, the one who has taken ablution, the foremost Gautama. He is a Brahmin, a Brahma, the knower of Brahma, the possessor of a Brahma Nirvana attainment, the liberated one. He is a liberation, the one with the body of full liberation, the fully liberated one, the peaceful one, the state of peace. He is a Nirvana release, the one with peace, the one released in Nirvana. He is the most definitely delivered and nearly brought to an end, the one who has completed bringing to end pleasure and pain, the one with it has been, the one with residue body consumed. He is the invincible one, the incomparable one, the unmanifest one, the one not appearing, the one with no signs that would make him seen, the unchanging, the all-going, the all-pervasive, the subtle, the untainted, the seedless. He is the one without a speck of dust, dustless, stainless, which falls, disjoins, the one without sickness. He is the wide awake one by identity nature, the fully enlightened, the omniscient one, the super knower of all. Beyond the nature of parsing primary consciousness, he is a deep awareness, bearer of a form of non-duality. He is the one without conceptual thought, spontaneously accomplishing without any effort, the one enacting the enlightening deeds of the Buddhas throughout the three times. He is the Buddha, the one without a beginning or end, the beginning primordial Adi Buddha, the one without precedence, the singular eye of deep awareness, the one with no sense, deep awareness embodied. He is the one dustly gone. He is the powerful lord of speech, the magnificent speaker, the supreme being among speakers, the ruler of speaker, the best of those speaking, the very best, the lion of speaker, unconquerable by others, seeing all around. He is supreme joy itself. With a garland of brilliance, beautiful to behold, he is the magnificent light, the blazing one, Vishnu, beloved of Sri, the core at the heart, the illuminator with hands that are rays of blazing light, the best of the great physicians. He is the most preeminent one, the unsurpassed remover of thorny pains. He is the celestial tree of all medications with none left out, the great nemesis of the kindnesses of disturbing emotions. He is the beauty marks of the world's three planets, the lovely one, the glorious one, with a mandala of lunar and zodiac constellation stars. He is the one extending to the ends of space in the 10 directions, the great ascending of the banner of Dharma. He is the unique extension of an umbrella over the wandering world, which is a mandala circle of love and compassion. He is the glorious one, the powerful lord of the lotus dance, great master of all the pervasive, the one with an umbrella of precious gems. He is the great king of all the Buddhas, holder of the embodiment of all the Buddhas, great yoga of all the Buddhas, unique teaching of all the Buddhas. He is the glory of the empowerment of the Vajra jewels, powerful lord of the sovereign of all jewels, master of all Lokeshwaras, the powerful lord of the world. He is the sovereign of all Vajradharas, the holder of the Vajras. He is the great mind of all Buddhas, the one that is present in the minds of all Buddhas. He is the great enlightening body of all Buddhas. He is the beautiful speech, Saraswati, of all Buddhas. He is the Vajra Sun, the great illuminator, the Vajra Moon, the stainless light. He is a great desire, the one that begins with non-desire, blazing light of various color. He is the Vajra posture of the fully enlightened, the bearer of the Dharma, the consort of the Buddhas. He is the glorious one, the one that is born from the lotus of the Buddhas, the keeper of the treasure of omniscient deep awareness. He is the bearer of diverse illusions. He is the king. He is the bearer of Buddhas, pure awareness mantras. He is the great one. He is the Vajra Sharp, the great sword, the supreme syllable, totally pure. He is the great vehicle, Mahayana, the quarter of suffering. He is the great weapon, Vajra Dharma. He is the trump of the trumpet, Vajra Profound. He is a Vajra intelligence, the knower of things and how they exist. He is the perfected state of very far-reaching attitude, the wearer of all Bhumi levels of mind as adornment. He is the lack of a true identity nature of totally pure existing thing. He is a correct deep awareness, the core light of the moon. He is a great diligence, applied, illusions net, sovereign of all tantras, the one that is superb. He is the possessor of Vajra, postures and seats, without an except. He is the all-round excellent Samanta Vajra. He is excellent intelligence. He is the womb of the earth, Chiti Garva, the support of the wandering world. He is the great womb of all the Buddhas, the bearer of a circle of assorted emanations. He is the supreme self-nature of all functional phenomena, the bearer of the self-nature of all functional phenomena. He is the non-arising extent which purposes diverse, the bearer of the nature of all existing things, great discriminating awareness in a single moment. He is the bearer of comprehension of all existing things, the clear realization of all existing things. He is the able seer with foremost intelligence, the end point of that which is perfectly so. He is the immovable one, extremely pure by identity nature, the bearer of the purified state of the perfect, fully enlightened ones. He is the one having pure cognition of all Buddhas, the flame of deep awareness, the excellent clear light. 24 verses on equalizing deep awareness. He is the fulfiller of wish for alms. He is super, the one totally purifying all of the worst rebirth states. He is the ultimate of all limited being, the guardian, the complete liberator of all sentient being. He is the hero in the battle with disturbing emotions, the unique one, the slayer of the insolent arrogance of the enemy's unawareness. He is the intelligence, bearer of an enamored tone, the one with glory, bearer of forms with heroic and disdainful tone. He is the one pounding with a 100 clubs in his hands. He is the dancer with a pounding down of his feet. He is the one with glory, the user of the 100 user's hand, the dancer across the sectors using the expanse of the sky. He is the one standing on the surface of the mandala of the earth, pressing down on the surface with a single foot. He is the one standing on the nail of his large toe, pressing down on the tip of Brahma's egg-like world. He is the singular item, the item regarding phenomena that is non-dual. He is the deepest truth item, the imperishable power Lord, the one that lacks what is fearful. He is the item with a variety of revealing forms, the one that has continuity of mind, of passing consciousness. He is a joyful awareness of existent things without an exception. He is a joyful awareness of voidness, the highest intelligence, the one gone beyond the longing desires and the likes of compulsive existence. He is a great joyful awareness regarding the three planes of compulsive existence. He is the pure white one, a brilliant white cloud with beautiful light, beams of the autumn moon, with an exquisite face, the mandala of a youthful sun, which light from his nails, a great passionate red, which sapphire blue hair knotted on top, and wearing a great sapphire on top of his locks. He is the glorious one with the radiant luster of a magnificent gem, having as jewelry emanations of Buddha. He is the shaker of spears of hundreds of war, the one with great force, with his extra physical powerful leg. He is the holder of the great state of mindfulness as well as the facts of reality. He is the ruler of the absorbed concentration of the four types of mindfulness state. He is the fragrance of the love blossoms on the branches leading to the purified states, the cream atop the ocean of good qualities of the dusty gone ones. He is the one knowing the mode of travel with the eightfold pathway minds, the one knowing the pathway minds of the perfect, fully enlightened. He is the one having great adherence to all sentient beings, but without having adherence, like the sky. He is the one entering the minds of all sentient beings, having speed in accord with the minds of all sentient beings. He is the one with awareness of the powers and objects of all sentient beings, the one who captures the hearts of all sentient beings. He is the one with awareness of the items and the reality of the five aggregate factors, the one who holds the full purity of the five aggregate factors. He is the one standing at the end of every definite deliverance, the one who is skilled in that which brings every definite deliverance. He is the one standing on the path for every definite deliverance, the one who is indicating every definite deliverance. He is the one who is uprooted compulsive existence with its 12 foldings, the holder of their purifications, having the 12 fold objects, having the aspect of a mode of travel of the fourfold truth. He is the holder of the realization of the eightfold awareness. He is the points of truth in 12-fold aspect, the knower of reality in 16 aspect, the fully enlightened through 20 aspects, the enlightened Buddha, the super knower of all. He is the one making knowable millions of lightning emanation bodies of innumerable Buddhas. He is the clear realization of everything in a moment, the knower of the objects of all moments of mind. He is the skillful means of the modes of travel of the various vehicles of mind, the one who makes knowable the aims of the wandering world. He is the one who is definitely delivered threefold to the vehicles of mind, the one who has established as the fruit of Ikayana, the single vehicle of a mind. He is the identity nature, totally pure of the spirits of disturbing emotions. He is the depleter of the spirits of karma. He is the one who has fully crossed over the ocean of currents, the one who has emerged from the wilderness by means of the yoga. He is the one fully rid of the disturbing emotions, the auxiliary disturbing emotions, and the general disturbing emotion, together with all their habits. He is a discriminating awareness and a great compassion as skillful means, the one fulfilling the aims of the wandering world meaningfully without fail. He is the one with objects of all conceptual discernment gotten rid of, the one with objects of partitioning consciousness brought to a halt. He is the cognitive object in reference to the minds of all limited beings, the one that abides in the minds of all sentient beings. He is the innermost stance of the minds of all sentient beings, the one who is passing as the equality of their mind. He is the one bringing satisfaction to the minds of all sentient beings. He is the joy of the mind of sentient beings. He is the culminating point of actualization, the one which confusion departed. He is the one which every mistake dispelled. He is the intelligence not indecisively wavering, the one that is a threefold, the one fulfilling everyone's aims with an identity nature of three constituents. He is the object in reference to the five aggregate factors, the one throughout the three times, the one that makes things individually knowledgeable in every instances. He is the one which manifests total enlightenment in an instant, the bearer of all the Buddha's self-nature. He is the one with an enlightening body that is incorporeal, the foremost of enlightening bodies, the one that makes knowledgeable millions of enlightening bodies. He is the one exhibiting everywhere of varieties of form. He is the great gem, Ratnaketu, the crowning level. 15 verses on the accomplishing deep awareness. He is the one to be realized by all the fully enlightened. He is the purified state of a Buddha, the peerless. He is the one that is not a syllable, the one comes forth from hidden mantra's womb, the triad of families of a great hidden mantra. He is the creator of every significance of hidden mantra. He is the great creative energy drop, that which is not a syllable. He is the great void having five syllables and creative drop void having six syllables. He is the possessor of all aspects, that which has not an aspect. He is the bearer of the 16 creative drops and half of their half. He is the one without phases beyond count, holder of the peak of the fourth level of mental stability. He is the advanced awareness of the phases of all levels of mental stability, the knower of the families and caste of absorbed concentration. He is the one with the enlightening body of absorbed concentration, the foremost of enlightening bodies, the ruler of all Sammukkaya enlightening bodies of full use. He is the one with a Nirvanakaya enlightening body of emanations, the foremost of the enlightening bodies, holder of the lineage of Buddha's emanations. He is the one issuing forth various emanations in the 10 directions, the one fulfilling the aims of the wandering world, whatever they may be. He is the chief of the deities over the deities, the chief of the gods, the overlord of the devilish non-god, the chief of the immortals, the guru of the gods, the destroyer and the powerful lord of the destroyers. He is the one with the wilderness of compulsive existence crossed over, the unique indicator, the guru for the wandering world. He is renowned throughout the world's 10 directions, the master of genius giving of the Dharma, the great one. Armored with the armor of love, coated with a coat of male compassion, wielder of a sword of discriminating awareness and a bow and arrow, he is the one who finishes the battle against disturbing emotions and unawareness. He is the heroic one, enemy of the Mara demonic forces, subduer of the Maras, the one who brings fear of the four Maras to an end, defeater of the military forces of all Mara. He is the fully enlightened, the leader of the world. He is the one worthy of offering, worthy of praise, the one for prostration, worthy of being honored, forever in paintings, worthy of souls of respect, most worthy of veneration, worthy for homage, the highest guru. He is the one traversing the world's three plane in a single stride, the one striding forth endlessly, just like space. He is the one with triple knowledge, proficiency in the sacred, clean and pure, possessor of the six type of heightened awareness and the six type of closed mindfulness. He is a bodhisattva, a great minded mahasattva, the one with a great extra physical power, the one gone beyond the world, situated at the end point of far-reaching discriminating awareness, Prajnaparamita. He is the one who has come to reality through discriminating awareness. He is the one with all knowledge of self and the knowledge of others, helpful to all, the foremost person of all. He is the one who has gone beyond all comparison, the super sovereignty of knowing and what is to be known. He is the master of generous giving of karma, the most preeminent, the one who shows the meaning of the fourfold mudra seals. He is the one most fitting to be helped and shown respect by the worldly, by those traversing the three pathways of definite deliverance. He is the purity and the glory of the deepest truth, the portion of excellence of the world's three planes, the great one, the one bringing all enrichment, the one having glory. He is the Manjushri, the lovely and glorious, supreme among those possessing glory. Five verses on the deep awareness of the five dustly gone ones. Homage to you, granter of the best boon, the foremost Vajra. Homage to you, the endpoint of what's perfectly so. Homage to you, the home of whiteness. Homage to you, the Buddha's purified state. Homage to you, the Buddha's attachment. Homage to you, the Buddha's desire. Homage to you, the Buddha's enjoyment. Homage to you, the Buddha's play. Homage to you, the Buddha's smile. Homage to you, Buddha's shining love. Homage to you, Buddha's peace. Homage to you, Buddha's state of mind. Homage to you, rising from non to existence. Homage to you, arising from the Buddhas. Homage to you, rising from space. Homage to you, arising from deep awareness. Homage to you, illusion state. Homage to you, the Buddha's dancer. Homage to you, everything for everyone. Homage to you, enlightening body of deep awareness. The mantras. Om Sarva Dharma Abhaye Svabhava Visuddhe Vajra Om. Om, the total purity of all existence by self nature, non-dual existence, total Vajra I Om. Prakriti Pradishuddhaya Sarva Dharma Yatatara Sarva Tathagata Gyan Manjushri Parishuddhana Upadhyaya. That which is the completely pure nature of all existence takes the form in need of the completely purified Manjushri, the enlightening body of deep awareness of all dustly gone. Om Sarva Tathagata Hridaye Hara Hara Om Him Ru Bhagavan Gyanamurti Bhagiswara Mahavacha Sarva Dharma Gaganamal Suparishuddha Dharma Dhatu Gyan Garva Aha. Aha, the heart of all the dustly gone, take out whom he, vanquishing master, surpassing all, embodied deep awareness, powerful Lord of space, the great one who ripens the complete total purity of all the existent, stainless like space, home of deep awareness of the spirit of reality. Five verses as an epilogue. Then the glorious holder of the Vajra, joyful and delighted with palms pressed together, bowing to the guardian, the vanquishing master, surpassing all, the justly gone one, the fully enlightened. Together with the other guardians of many varied sorts, Lord of the hidden, Vajrapanis, king of the furious, loudly proclaimed these words of praise. We rejoice, O guardian, excellent, excellent, well said. For us, the great guardian aim has now been fulfilled, the attainment of a perfect full enlightenment state. And for the wandering world also, lacking a guardian, wishing for the fruit of complete liberation, this excellent and pure pathway mind has been shown, the mode of travel of illusion's nest. This cognitive object in need of the Buddha, having a profound and extensive broad scope, the great aim, fulfilling the aims of the wandering world, has been expounded by the perfect, fully enlightened one, a consort of the deepest truth, names of the vanquishing master, surpassing all, the deep awareness being Manjushri, expounded by the vanquishing master, the dustly gone, Om Sakyamuni, hereby completed.